As we discussed in the previous part, we will discuss the signals, different type of signals and different type of systems. The remaining part in this unit is the analogy between an electrical system and mechanical system. Means how you can correlate the mechanical system with the electrical system. So the outline for this presentation is, so first we will discuss about the analogous system, then we will discuss the force voltage analogy, and then force current analogy, some examples on analogous system and their mechanical equivalent network. So if we talk about the electrical system, okay, electrical circuit, so we have taken an example of a simple RLC series circuit. Here we can see that resistance, inductor and capacitor are connected in series, and a current is flowing in the loop and the excitation is E. So if we apply KVL in this circuit, you can easily write that E equals to I into R plus L di by dt plus 1 upon C integration of I into dt. Now if we further reduce this equation into the form by putting I equals to dq by dt. So in form of charge, the equation will converted as E equals to R into dq by dt plus L d2q by dt square plus 1 upon C q. Okay. So this is a differential equation. This is a first order differential equation. You can see here. Okay. So now if we move forward for a parallel circuit. So for a parallel circuit, if we apply KVL at any node, this is the R, L and C connected in parallel, and the voltage across the each element is E, and if we apply a current I, then I will be given by, if we put apply KVL at this node, so I equals to E upon R, this is the current in R, resistance R, and 1 upon L E into dt, okay, so and C into dE by dt. This is the current in capacitor. So here, to convert this equation into the differential equation like in the series RLC circuit, we have to put phi equals to integration of E into dt. So E equals to d phi by dt. So put this value in this equation, this equation will be converted into the differential form. So I will be equal to 1 upon R d phi by dt plus 1 upon L into phi plus C d2 phi by dt square. Okay, so these are the equation by applying KVL and KCL in series RLC circuit as well as in parallel RLC circuit. So you can easily calculate them. Yeah, you already studied them in your 12th or in your basic electrical engineering. So now we move forward. So now we talk about a mechanical system. So mechanical system can be of two types. First is the translational systems and second is a rotational system. Translational systems. So what is a translational system? If a body is moving in a straight line, then the motion is known as translational motion. Like if you are pulling a cart, or if you are pushing a block on the floor, then the motion produced is your translational motion. Okay. So if you are, your motion is in a line, then you are, you can say that the motion is a translational motion. So if motion is translational, then mainly three type of force are could be present in this system that resist the motion of the body. Suppose if we applied a force to push a block on the floor, then there could be three type of resisting motion, resisting force that resist the motion of the block. So we will discuss then these forces one by one. So first force is inertia force. So everybody has its own mass. Due to the mass, okay, the inertia force exists. So inertia force is given by mass into acceleration. F equals to m into a, mass into acceleration. So if this is the body having a mass m, and we have to displace this mass into this side, we applied a force to pull this block in this direction, then the displacement is xt, but due to the mass, there is a resisting force occurs, that is known as inertia force FMT. FMT is given by M into AT, or FM equals to, is this acceleration is given by dV by dt, where V is the velocity. So we can represent the acceleration into the differential form, that is given by dV by dt. And also the velocity is a function of displacement, and V equals to dx by dt. So here we can also represent this force as M into d2xt by dt square. Okay, so this force can be represented in this in xt domain, in vt in form of vt, or in form of acceleration, where vt is the velocity and xt is the displacement of the body. Second force that could resist the motion is the friction. So if we want to pull the body in the in liquid or in viscous medium, then there is also a damping force occurs, that is known as damping force Fd into T, and this force is directly proportional to the velocity. So this force Fd into T equals to B into Vt, where B is the damping coefficient. B is the damping coefficient, V into T, and V is a function of x. So we can write Vt equals to B into dxt by dt. So this Fdt is a function of B into dxt by dt. So here you can calculate the force due to the damping. Okay, so these two forces are inertia force and damping force. The last force we should discuss is spring force. If a spring is connected, then if you pull a body along any direction, then a potential energy is stored in this spring as per the displacement. So we can say that the restoring force due to the spring is directly proportional to the displacement x. So Fkt is equals to k into xt, where k is the restoring spring constant, you can say. So here we see that the three resisting force we converted into the form of xt. Fmt equals to md square xt by dt square, b is equals to dxt by dt, and then spring force k into xt. So if we talk about a system, okay, we apply the D'Alembert principle, as you already heard about this. So what is the D'Alembert principle? For anybody, the algebraic sum of externally applied force and the sum of resisting force in any direction is zero. Means, agar koi body hai, us body pe aapne koi force apply kiya hai, to wo force should be equals to the sum of all forces resisting the applied force. Okay? So if the applied force is Ft, then the resisting forces are md to xt by dt square plus b into dxt by dt. This is the damping force, this is the force due to the inertia, and this is the force due to the spring kxt. So this is the equation for the applied force for a mechanical translational system. Similarly, if the system is rotational, so just similar to the inertia force, here we have the inertia torque. So J is the inertia torque, B is the damping torque, and K is the spring torque. And here in translational system, we show the displacement in form of xt, but in a rotational system, the displacement in form of angle. Or we can say that here is here the displacement is angular displacement. So we represent this displacement by theta t. Okay? So this equation we can also represent that j, sorry, here I have written a little bit, I forgot. This we can represent as j d2 theta t by dt square. So this is a second order differential equation. So this is for rotational system and this is for the translational system. Okay, so this is the system. Now if we comparing this equation, if we compare this force equation and the voltage equation, previously we studied, this is the voltage equation. Okay, so if we compare this equation, voltage equation, and the force equation, this analogy is known as force voltage analogy, because we comparing the force equation with the voltage equation. Okay, here in the force agar hum compare karte hain, to we can see that in the translational system the force F is exist. Theek hai, to electrical system mein us jagah pe hamare paas kya hai, voltage E hai. Agar hum baat karte hain jo hamara second order ka coefficient hai d2 by dt square, wahan par mechanical system mein ya translational system mein hamare paas M hai, to electrical system mein hamare paas wahan pe inductor aapko milta hai. These are the similarity, the analogy. Yeah, these are not equal. These are the analogous component. Ki agar mechanical system mein mass hai, to electrical system mein uski jagah par L hai. These are not equal, but these are analogous component. Remember this. Now, the stiffness constant, spring constant K hai agar, to wahan par 1 upon C hota hai. Theek hai? Agar mechanical system mein humari equation mein B aa raha hai, jo ki first order coefficient hai, to electrical system mein R aata hai. Similarly, वहाँ पर अगर हमारे पास x है displacement, तो electrical system में उसकी जगह पर हम क्या use करते हैं, charge. ठीक है. Now if we compare this force equation with the equation of current, this equation, okay, then this analogy is known as force current analogy, this force current analogy. So you just have to compare the equations. So similarly, as we compare in force voltage analogy, in force current analogy, force is analogous to I, M is analogous to C, and B is analogous to 1 upon R or conductance, and stiffness or spring constant K is analogous to 1 upon L, and displacement X is analogous to flux linkage phi, and velocity is analogous to E. Okay, so these are the force voltage and force current analogy. So for a rotational system, similarly you can easily compare a rotational system with an electrical system. So this is the TV analogy, torque voltage analogy. So in the rotational system, torque is equivalent to E, and moment of inertia J is equivalent to L, and damping coefficient B equals to R, your B is analogous to R, stiff coefficient K is equivalent to C, angular displacement theta is analogous to charge Q, and angular velocity omega is analogous to current I. Similarly, we can prepare a chart for torque and current analogy. So for that, you have to compare the equation of current in electrical system and this equation of rotational system. Okay, so when we compare this, we found that the torque is analogous to current I, and moment of inertia is analogous to capacitance C, and damping coefficient is analogous to reciprocal of R or 1 upon R, and stiffness coefficient K is analogous to the reciprocal of inductance 1 upon L, and angular displacement omega is analogous to flux linkage phi. Okay, so these are the analogy of a system. So now we how to draw an analogous system. So like in the given example, you see here that this is a hinge support where a spring is connected and a damper is connected, and mass is connected to this. This is a spring, damper, mass again, damper, mass again, and this is the applied force. This is the applied force. Now for this force, you have to draw a diagram that is comparable to, or you can say that is analogous to this mechanical system. So for the system, first you have to find out the displacement in the system. So in this system, here we found this displacement x1, x2 and x3. At each mass, you found a displacement, and the number of displacement will be equal to the number of loops in the electrical equivalent. This is the main point. Remember, the number of displacement will be equal to the number of loops in the electrical circuit. So first we found that we have three displacement, so we have three loops, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Analogous to the displacement 1, 2 and 3. Now this applied force is always work as a source. So force voltage analogy mein F ko hum analogy kaise karte hai? Voltage se. So F is applied force. Now this M is analogous to inductor L. Theek hai? Ab in this loop, ab hume ye check karna hai ki between X1 and X2 what is common. Theek hai? Yani ke X1 is a loop, X2 is a loop, and between these loops, what is common is B1. So, between this loop and this loop, this is the loop due to X1, this is the loop due to X2, and this is the loop due to X3. So, X1 or X2 ke beech mein B1 common hai. So, X1 or X2 ye hai, to iske beech mein B1 humne common bana diya, and B1 is analogous to R. So, we are putting R here. Sir, in X2 and X3, yani ke dusre aur teesre loop ke beech mein kya common tha? ये दोनों चीजें कॉमन थी. ठीक है, तो जो चीजें यहां पे कॉमन थी उसको बी को हमने आर से रिप्लेस कर दिया और के को हमने कैपेसिटर से रिप्लेस कर दिया. ये दोनों चीजें कॉमन आ गई हमारी, तो इस लूप के बीच में इनको कॉमन हमने दिखाया. ठीक है, और फिर सिमिलरली थर्ड लूप इंडिपेंडेंट है और इस लूप में हमारे पास ये भी है और ये भी है, तो ये दोनों चीजें यहां पे आ गई. नाउ बात करते हैं मास की. मास को हम इंडक्टर से रिप्लेस करते हैं, चूंकि ये फर्स्ट लूप में था इसको फर्स्ट में दिखाया, सेकंड मास सेकंड लूप में था इसमें दिखाया, थर्ड मास थर्ड लूप में था तो इसको हमने यहां दिखा दिया. दिस इज हाउ वी ड्रॉ ए एनालॉगस इलेक्ट्रिकल इक्विवेलेंट इन द ऑफ ए मैकेनिकल सिस्टम. ओके, सो दीज आर द स्टेप्स. आई होप आई ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन द कंप्लीट सिस्टम बाय यूजिंग द एग्जांपल, सो नो नीड टू एक्सप्लेन दिस एज मच. सो दिस इज द अगेन अ सिस्टम. सो नाउ फाइंड हाउ मच डिस्प्लेसमेंट आर हेयर, x1 एंड x2. See, x1 and x2. So, how many loops you have to form? Mainly two loops. x1, x2, yes, 1 and 2 is the other loop. Okay. So x1 and x2, sorry, this is the force current analogy. I'm sorry, I have discussed about the force voltage analogy, but this question is of force current analogy. In this system, as in force voltage analogy, we express our displacement as the loop, but in force current analogy, we express our displacement as node. So x1 is a node and x2 is a node. As in previous example, we take a displacement as loops. But in this example, क्योंकि हमें force current analogy से बनाना है, तो हम यहाँ पर जो displacement है, उनको node से represent करेंगे. तो x1 is a node, x2 is a node. Now see, x1 और x2 से क्या-क्या connected है? Now this x1, if this is x1, ठीक है, and this is x2, x2 से सबसे पहले हमारा applied force connected है. Applied force is your current, ठीक है? अब इस x2 से m2 भी connected है. This is m2. इस x2 से हमारा ये damping b3 भी connected है. This b3. All are connected to the node x2, ठीक है? और इस नोड x2 नोड के बीच में और x1 नोड के बीच में क्या कॉमन है? ये दोनों चीजें कॉमन है. तो इन दोनों चीजों को हमने x1 नोड और x2 नोड के बीच में हमने कॉमन दिखाया, क्योंकि ये इसके और इसके बीच में कॉमन है. इस नोड पे भी कनेक्टेड है और इस नोड पे भी कनेक्टेड है. सिमिलरली जब हम x1 नोड की बात करते हैं, तो इस पे मास कनेक्ट है, इस पे ये k1 कनेक्टेड है और इस पे b2 कनेक्टेड है. तो इस x1 पे मास कनेक्टेड हो गया, b2 कनेक्टेड हो गया और k1 कनेक्टेड हो गया. ठीक है, दिस इज हाउ वी रिप्रेजेंट ए मैकेनिकल सिस्टम in this analogous form. Now again draw the diagram by replacing the analogous element of electrical system from your table. So B ke analogous kya hoga, M ke analogous kya hoga aur R ke analogous kya hoga, theek hai, usse hum isko draw kar lete hain. So this is how we can draw the force electrical equivalent circuit for force voltage analogy and force current analogy. Thank you. You can also post your queries regarding this in the comment section. Okay, thank you.